Hello, I'm Alexandra. Welcome to the Rock Your Goddess Life series. Today we are exploring Self-Care 101, how to honor your goddess body and create a beautiful life. So I want to start off first with what is self-care? I see self-care as a way to honor your unique body and also truly care for yourself mentally, emotionally, and physically, and to align your life with who you are. Sounds simple, right? But I think in today's world, it's truly a revolutionary act for women to take care of themselves in this way. And I didn't used to always believe this. I have always needed a lot of self-care. It's just the way that I'm wired. And I used to think that it was a weakness, that I was weak because I needed a lot of self-care. And when I looked around, it didn't seem like other women needed a lot of self-care, so I just ended up thinking that there was something seriously wrong with me. And now, after working with hundreds of women, I've realized that if women really tune into their bodies, most of us need a lot of self-care. And I know that you know that. But we are strong, so we can push through it, and we can force things, and we can make it all happen. But the question is, why are we doing it and what is the cost? I love a quote by Krishnamurti, and it's no measure of health to be well-adjusted to a profoundly sick society. A little intense, I know. But I think it gets the point across of just because something's normal in our society does not mean that it's health-giving or it's something that we should model. So in this class, we will look at challenging some of our ideas about self-care and also hopefully support you in being a well-resourced woman and at least give yourself a chance to thrive. So many of us don't even give ourselves a chance to thrive. And imagine like a world where we as women took care of ourselves. We treated ourselves with love and respect and compassion, and we loved our bodies. We loved ourselves, we loved our lives, and we truly enjoyed being women. Like, that would be awesome, right? So that's what I'm committed to. That's what this class is about. And I believe that self-care can heal the world. And that sounds a little radical and maybe ridiculous, but what I know is that when women are connected to themselves, when they feel empowered, they create things and they change things. And this isn't about feeling all fluffy and light and good and rainbows and sunshines all the time. This is about plugging into something bigger than ourselves. And it's about nourishing ourselves so that we can engage in the world and be who we are here to be. Ready to rock? Let's take a quick look at the top 10 big ideas for this class. So big idea number one is know and trust your beautiful body. And in this big idea, we're going to explore why your body is so miraculous and take a look at body image and learning about your body and what your unique essence pace is. And then finally, trusting your body, that your body is not the enemy. She is your partner and she wants you to optimize and actualize, and realizing that you're more magnificently beautiful and radiant than you thought possible. Big idea number two is say yes to yourself. We'll take a look at making self-care a priority, then asking for help, and imagining who you are when you're doing self-care and when you're not, and looking at what's truly essential and what you can let go of and say no to, so you have more space to engage in self-care practices that will nourish you. Big idea number three is energy needs and energy drains. And in this one, we'll look at creating a blueprint that will help you thrive. What makes you feel best? We'll explore eating, moving, sleeping, and mental training. And then we'll also look at energy drains. What is draining your energy in your environment, relationships, career, mind, body, spirit, health, money, and finances. Big idea number four is self-care as a way of life. This isn't about just going through the motions. It's about shifting your perspective about what self-care entails. It's not about going to do something relaxing over here and then go back to your crazy life over there. It's a way of being in everything you do, an integration process of coming back to yourself again and again, and cultivating a mindset and intentional practice, because life won't go as planned, so finding ways to find your own flow. Big idea number 5 is start and end your day right. What is an ideal morning rhythm and ritual for you? And also, what's an ideal evening routine for you? We'll also look at some daily journal questions that will help support you, and I'll share a little bit about my morning and evening routines. Big idea number 6 is practice loving yourself. This is about becoming aware of the ways that you talk to yourself. Imagine, what if someone was following you around all day saying, you suck, you're stupid, you're ugly, you're never gonna figure it out, you can't do anything right, you're hopeless, why even try? This self-care stuff is totally ridiculous. You a goddess, ha, what a joke. Who do you think you are? So we all have different versions of that. So we'll explore that and how to cultivate more self-compassion and love and not believe all the voices that swirl around in our head. Big idea number 7 is happies and goddess adventures. And these are all about fun and play. Happies are little rituals you can do daily that will increase your mojo and joy throughout your day. They're the simple things that light you up, that help you stay connected to yourself throughout the day. And goddess adventures are those times when you want to do something new, creative, outrageous, or fun. You get out of your comfort zone and experience a new dimension of yourself and connect to your childlike, playful, and adventurous self. Big idea number 8 is honor your natural rhythms and cycles. So we'll look at daily rhythms. The sun rises and the sun sets. So finding your ebb and your flow. And then we'll look at monthly cycles and seasons of your life. That there are certain times of the year that a rose blossoms and a fruit ripens. There is a rhythm and a flow for our lives as well. We aren't machines. So this idea is about creating spaciousness to flourish. Big idea number 9 is unplug, silence, journaling, and nature. Talk about disconnecting from technology, taking time for silence to digest and integrate, that it's okay to be on and it's okay to be off, that your life isn't one big inhale. And seeing journaling as a way to connect to yourself and getting outside and experiencing nature and feeling the beauty and the abundance and the rhythm all around you. Big idea number 10 is you're enough. This is about slaying the not good enough dragons. In order for us to take exquisite care of ourselves, we have to feel like we are enough. So we'll talk about the limiting beliefs and how we can practice being splendidly imperfect. And we'll look at what's propelling us forward in our life. What's the motivation for what you're doing every day in your life? And then imagining what would life look like if you were good enough. You didn't have to prove anything. You did what you did because you wanted to. You expressed yourself freely. You felt connected to your essence and your values. And you know that what you did mattered, that you mattered. You stopped wasting your energy, comparing, competing, and just let yourself be. Be who you are unapologetically. That is what I'm talking about. So those are the top 10 big ideas. Let's jump in.